This is the minimal API endpoint that relies heavily on the result type for validation. It is all implemented in a procedural style all the way through. And this is the same code, only implemented by applying the Fluent result type and declarative style. Would you like it better this way? This code is functional, it is shorter and more expressive. In this video, I will show you the first steps in the direction of functional error handling with the functional result type rather than the procedural result type I have here. That would prepare you for more difficult situations, such as functional async await patterns. Yes, that is all possible. But first things first, there is nothing functional or declarative in my current code. This endpoint invests a lot of effort to validate the inputs first. It is processing a complex web request. I have no objections to the amount of work performed in this method. It must create many small domain objects before constructing a large entity and saving it to the database. Still, this code demonstrates a procedural result pattern. The alternative is the functional result pattern, as I have already indicated. You can learn about the naive result type from my previous video in which I created this class. Let me just briefly walk you through it. The result exposes a Boolean flag that tells whether it contains a value or an error. The constructor is private. You would create new instances by using one of the static factory methods. The success receives a value and sets the isSuccess flag to true. The failure factory method receives the error and sets the isSuccess to false. This is the bare result type of the kind you will find in many libraries and projects. And this is the code it produces. I notice a few issues with this code. I will briefly walk you through so that you can see this code's drawbacks too. The endpoint must return as many validation errors as it can discover. We expect the caller to fix all individual errors before contacting the web server again. Therefore, I am collecting the field-level errors in this object. Each validation step would either produce one small object required later or an error for the specific field. I would occasionally stop further processing and return HTTP status 400 bad request along with a list of all errors discovered up to this point. That happens when the next step assumes the existence of previously validated objects. Validation happens in waves. One wave ends here, followed by two more sections of validation and object preparation work. We are now ready to start changing our mindset. So welcome to this video at last. We shall augment the traditional procedural result type and turn it into a powerful, flexible, functional result that supports Fluent validation, the composition of errors, and ultimately produces a tremendously short and expressive code. It is such a large piece of work that I cannot possibly cover it all in this video alone. Still, we can do a great deal of it if we just start a new class, which I will call Functional Result. It is static. It will only contain the extension methods. That is a typical practice in functional programming. I want to extend the behavior of the result type with a method, which I will call Test for now. I want to show you how it comes that we need such extensions. That will lead us to some interesting discoveries. We often need to transform the object contained in the result so to produce another object. The trouble is that we cannot imagine what the caller might have in mind. We reach out for higher order functions. I'm asking for the mapping from the type of the value into some new type. I will change the numbering of these generic types so they make more sense. Then we start by checking. If we have a success result, then we are safe to take the value from inside of it and apply the mapping. Observe how I don't know the types, nor do I know what the mapping will produce. Yet you will know from a glance what this code is doing. Still, I cannot tell anyone I've got this mapped object. I might return it from the method, but that will cause another problem. What shall I return in the case of a failure? I have no substitute object to return here. This riddle has an ingenious solution in functional programming. It's not just the mapped object we have got here. We have got an entire success object of a different kind. Observe how I have changed the result from T1 to T2. That is what the mapping does. The result type of the method would not be the generic type parameter, but the entire result type of the mapped type T2. The success produced in this branch is only one possible result. The other possibility is the failure. It will be the failure of the changed type T2, containing the same error as the original result. I can turn this method into an expression now that everything is clear. Success produces a new success with the mapped value. Failure produces a new failure that retains the same error object. I will also rename this extension method to map. This method lets you optionally map the value if it is there and silently do nothing if there is no value. Even though the result is defined on two types, the value and the error, we assume that mapping is applied to the value. The result type lets you program the happy path and only deal with the error at the end. I will now define two other functional result mappings. Before that, let me remind you that you can download the entire source code from this video from my Patreon page. Patrons are the reason why this channel is free for everyone. By becoming the patron, you are helping hundreds of other fellow programmers watch all the videos on my channel for free. Now, the mappings. The same way we used to map the value, we can also map the error. Success would remain success, retaining the contained value, only changing the type of the error. However, the failure would change. Not only does the error type change, but we must also pass the error object through the mapping function. The third mapping extension method would be the most powerful. It is common in functional languages to call it match. It lets the caller transform an entire result object into some type T result, using one of the two mapping functions. It would either take the success value and apply the value mapping or map the error object instead. Either way, the caller would obtain the object of type T result, but without knowing exactly how that object came to be. Isn't that wonderful? There is one more standard operator you will see on functional types. It is usually called bind and it is somewhat similar to map. The difference is that the mapping produces a new result rather than just a value. The implementation is straightforward, which is typical in functional programming. Either return the result produced by the mapping function or repeat the error. This completes the first step in introducing the fluent declarative, functional if you wish, result type. It won't be helpful in a realistic piece of code such as this minimal API endpoint. Still, you must make this initial step if you want to go any further. Let's see how the new result extensions will affect the validation. In the first step, we obtain the result. Then the following line possibly adds an error to the list. I have a better idea. We can start from the result of publisher and map its error into something else. This code is still experimental. Don't worry, I will make it better in a minute. The idea is to add this string error to the validation errors object along with the field name. I need to fix the type. The error is a validation error response now. This is the principal idea of gradually adding errors to the list. There would still be the publisher object on success. I will now make the validation error response more useful. This method will return the modified object. It would always be the this reference. This coding pattern is typical in Fluent builders. For example, string builder returns this from each of its apply methods. That will simplify this lambda, as the validation error response returns itself this time. That is an entirely different approach to managing validation errors. I have changed the other steps into this new form, and that is as far as the bare functional result type will take you. There are a couple of obstacles ahead. One is that these mappings are mutable. That does not necessarily mean I'm violating the principles of functional programming, as the mutation is enclosed within this method. Still, I would expect something better here. The second issue is that all this code, which collects errors into a list, remains procedural. Collecting a list of errors into a result type goes beyond the result type alone. The last important issue, which I will not address in this video, is asynchronous mapping on a result. All these issues are orthogonal to the result type. We address them with separate sets of extensions. For example, I will show you one possible technique to collect errors in parallel. This is it. If you want an explanation of how I made the result type support the list of errors here, then shout out in the comments and I might explain that in a separate video. The point here is that I am mapping four independent validation operations into a record with four properties. It would be a validation error response if any of the individual validations failed. Back at the consuming code, I can delete all this code and substitute it with just one result object. It would be easy to attach the next stage then. I am pulling the book title validation into a separate method for clarity. Creating the book title domain model starts from the result of the previous four validations, using their positive outcome to make the subsequent step. That would make it a pair of objects when successful. The validation would now be the bind operation, combining the result of the first validation with the result of the second validation. Any of these may fail, but we only write the happy path. That is where my current result type will abandon me at last. The next operation on the result type is asynchronous. I would need asynchronous extensions on top of the functional result type I have now. I will just fix the compile time errors and leave the rest of this endpoint in its current procedural state. Still, the beginning of the method is promising. It can show us the path we desire. We want only to list the happy path operations one after another. Each operation alone might raise an error, but we ignore that until the very end, where we either produce the positive result if all previous operations succeeded, or produce the failure result otherwise. We are only one step away from designing the most powerful result package that would support everything we need. Common validation, error lists, and asynchronous validation. Stay tuned.